The Rite of Spring, one of the works that changed the world, one of the most revolutionary pieces ever written. A piece that Stravinsky, even himself, couldn't believe he'd written. He said it started off with a dream. He dreamt of a girl dancing herself to death. And he then said that he felt somehow that the Rite of Spring had come from outside him. He used to say, "I'm the vessel through which Le Sacre passed." In fact, of course, it was never quite as simple as that with Stravinsky, because he had taken an enormous number of old Russian folk tunes and he had remembered the village musicians for where he had grown up and lived. And he took these things and he deconstructed them. He tore them up rather like a cubist painting. But there is absolutely no doubt that nothing like this had ever been heard before. Of course, the first performance in May 1913 was a famous riot. People who were there remember that the very beginning of the piece, with its high bassoon making the sound of the earth cracking, that was heard with some kind of respectful silence. But the minute the famous dissonant, violent stamping chords began, people began to object louder and louder. And it was very clear that, as Stravinsky said, no one could hear the music at all. He could hear Nijinsky behind the stage screaming out numbers so that the dancers didn't get lost. There was still a great success. This is what people forget, is the people who loved it, and it was like a class war going on between the rich in the stalls and the poor in the balcony. The balconies gave it an enormous ovation, and apparently by the second performance, it was, the riot had stopped, and people were realizing that there was one of the great masterpieces in front of them. The final last dance, which is of such a rhythmic complexity that at first Stravinsky had absolutely no idea how to write it down. wonderful photographs of his manuscript without any bar lines. Just with all the chords and the rhythms before he could work out where someone should put the beat. Almost 100 years since its first performance, the piece still thrills, the piece still shocks.